small, but the greatest wrestler of all always stands tall. And I sure hope that I end up right in the XWF. So what are you gonna do when the XWF runs wild on you?
Good evening, wrestling fans, and welcome back to the Nation Network as we get ready for another exciting episode of the XWF. As we take a look at the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, heading to the ring. This is going to be a tag team matchup, and when it comes to the million-dollar man, who do you think he's going to get as a tag team partner?
Well, one thing we know about the million-dollar man, and that is that he will spare no expense when it comes to the very best. If you recall, I was a special referee at SummerSlam, and he had none other than Andre the Giant. Maybe he's going to bring Andre back. We'll find out in a moment, won't we?
That million-dollar championship wrapped tightly around the waist of the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. Well, who is it?
Well, you'll find out what he wants you to find out. In the meantime, have a seat. Oh, take a look at this.
Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, you've got to be kidding me.
Like I said, he doesn't waste anything when it comes to spare no expense. That's the name of the game when it comes to the million-dollar man. When you have a bottomless budget like that, you can just spend anything you want.
And his partner from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, indeed. Well, that is going to be a formidable tag team.
Well, going up against a formidable tag team, I suppose, in their own right, although we're not 100% sure because their opponents tonight, to my knowledge, have not been a tag team before either, so this ought to be a very interesting test for both teams just to see where they are in the overall scheme of things. But when it comes down to it, for me, I'm going to go and do what they always say, follow the money.
Indeed, I know you would. Shout out to everybody joining us here live on the Nation Network. J-Rock's in the house. Welcome aboard.
Look at Mr. Wonderful, man. He is just oozing confidence, which, hey, if you look like that, why wouldn't you?
Fans, we promised you on our last episode that tonight there would be a major announcement, and it's coming up. Shortly after this match, I will be one-on-one with Hulk Hogan, the owner of the XWF.
Oh, here comes old Hacksaw Jim Duggan waving Old Glory around. Now, I'm okay with the second part, but I'm not a big fan of Hacksaw Jim Duggan as a rule.
Well, I've got a funny feeling he's probably not a big fan of yours either.
That's fine by me.
Duggan flying that flag here for the crowd to see, and you can see right now this crowd is wholeheartedly behind Hacksaw.
Well, you know, I'm one of those people that never really care too much about the fans. I don't care if they boo me or they cheer me. Doesn't make a difference. They're not paying my bills.
Oh, and who's this?
From Paris Island,
Sergeant Slaughter!
Weighing in at 305 pounds, Sergeant Slugger!
Now, what do you think about this team?
Well, I think there's potential, I suppose. I don't know that they're going to be able to handle a team like this million-dollar team right here because DiBiase, he understands the business at hand. And he handpicked Mr. Wonderful. And I tell you right now, I think he's got the superior athlete. He's got the superior mind. And at the same point in time, he's got all that money behind him. Who knows what referees he may have purchased this week?
Yeah, indeed. We know that he's not above doing that.
Nope, he's not. But hey, at the end of the day, what do I always say? They're going to ask you if you won, not how you won.
Few words right there before the bell sounds between Sergeant Slaughter, Hacksaw Jim Duggan going to start things off against Ted DiBiase. And DiBiase opens up with a big right hand and now belly to back suplex. No, never mind. Atomic knee drop on Duggan.
Yeah, right off the bat, the Million Dollar Man. And you know, the best leaders are the ones that step up and show you how it's done. And I love the fact that DiBiase started the match.
Indeed, tag now made to Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff coming off that rope down across the arm. And now Snapmare takes Duggan over. Oh, what a big fist right to the forehead of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the native of Glens Falls, New York.
Glens Falls, whatever came out of Glens Falls besides Jim Duggan, and believe me, that's not setting a very high bar in my opinion.
Oh, big right hand right to the head, and Duggan, oh, he's been split open.
Well, you know what, this ain't ballet, and sometimes you're going to catch one, and he caught one, might have broke his nose, I'm not sure.
Wow, that blood really streaming down the face, and Duggan in trouble early on, diving to make the tag, and now here comes Sergeant Slaughter against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Duggan is down in the ring.
Yeah, this could be a big problem. He can't even get out. Referee should be counting him in the meantime, but look at this. Paul Orndorff distracted momentarily by the fact that Duggan was still in the ring, and that gave Sergeant Slaughter the open door.
Going for the cover now. Here's one, and a save made by the Million Dollar Man. Not sure he needed to do that.
Why in the world is Duggan still in the ring?
Well, the same reason DiBiase was in the ring. There's a DDT. Sergeant Slaughter landing on the canvas. There's one, and he got the shoulder up.
I would have said dropped him head first, but I think the jaw makes contact long before the rest.
Once again, the tie-up Irish whip to the ropes back out front. There's a clothesline. Orndorff now throwing him head first into the top turnbuckle. Big right hand to the ribs. Oh, look at this, unloading. Snapmare takes him over, and now DiBiase dropping a fist right to the head.
Well, right now, he and Orndorff really looking like a well-oiled machine, and makes me think that these two dudes might have what it takes.
Everybody right now nipping at the heels of the Steiner brothers, including the Crown, who we'll be seeing later on tonight. Sends him crashing into DiBiase, and now Duggan back in the ring, but that blood still streaming down the head, and Duggan taking a moment to acknowledge the crowd, and DiBiase taking advantage of the moment.
That's what it's all about right there. If you can't stay focused, and look at DiBiase showing the sign of the money. That's how he got here. That's how he got Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. And hey, like I said, you never know. Is that a $100 bill I see in the back pocket of that referee?
I doubt that very seriously. The officials here at the XWF have been above reproach up to this point in time. And now Hacksaw Jim Duggan coming up with a series of strikes. DiBiase's been rattled.
Well, that wound on the head of Duggan getting a little bit worse now, and the referee might have to get involved in this and stop the match.
Sergeant Slaughter tagging back in. And the sidewalk slam, DiBiase driven into the canvas. Now trying to find his way back to Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, but Sergeant Slaughter standing in between him and his tag team partner, inverted atomic knee drop, and DiBiase feeling that one.
Look at Duggan getting cheap shots in. There's a real hero for you. There's a role model.
As you know, the idea of tag team wrestling is to cut the ring in half, keep your opponent in your half of the ring, and things like that are going to happen.
Really? Well, just remember that when one of these two dudes gets caught in the other corner.
Sleeper hold now by Duggan, and DiBiase just barely escapes. Meantime, Orndorff and Sergeant Slaughter. Oh, nice neck breaker right there by Ted DiBiase, and Duggan rolling out to the floor. Smart move by Hacksaw Jim Duggan, don't you agree?
Well, I suppose technically it's a smart move. Could be a little bit of a coward's move as well. Realized he was about to lose the match, so instead he runs away.
DiBiase planting a boot right to the head. I disagree with that move. I think it is a smart move to get outside the ring, give yourself a chance to try and clear the cobwebs. You have a 10 count to get back in the ring.
Well, I don't know how many cobwebs he cleared during that time out there, because DiBiase just kept on beating him. And now look at this.
Duggan going after Paul Orndorff, but now DiBiase head first into the turnbuckle. There was no pad there. And now targeting the leg of Hacksaw Jim Duggan. I'll tell you, things going from bad to worse for Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And now DiBiase has them all. Oh, this could be the match. Pile driver, it's over.
Yeah, that should be the end of the match for sure. He goes for the cover, but now the referee not paying attention. Look at this. Oh, you talk about a travesty of justice.
Well, that's his own fault. If he hadn't taken the turnbuckle pad off, the referee wouldn't have to have gone back to it in the first place. DiBiase, victim of his own spoils here in this one. And now, ready. Oh, never mind. Duggan getting the upper hand for the moment. Big right hand, and down goes DiBiase.
Well, these two no strangers to one another. And look at this, throws him into the referee.
Awkward collision, to say the least. And now DiBiase taking advantage of it. And again, the head of Duggan has been busted wide open, and that blood getting worse by the moment.
Yeah, it's quickly, his face is becoming that proverbial crimson mask that we've often heard spoken of. There's the tag made, and now Mr. Wonderful, nice and fresh, coming back into the ring against what's left of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, but it doesn't appear that there's much.
Right to the eyes, and now look at Orndorff taunting Hulk Hogan. Or I beg your pardon, Sergeant Slaughter at ringside.
Orndorff right now bringing him back over to his corner. And to your point earlier, this is smart tag team wrestling.
It is smart tag team wrestling, whether you like it or not. There's a five count to get out of the ring, and they exercised that and made the most of it. But now Duggan fighting his way back as we look at that blood streaming into the eyes, and Duggan gonna take advantage of this opportunity and once again tags in Sergeant Slaughter. Tremendous action, ladies and gentlemen. This is our opening matchup. Once again, major announcement coming up later in the program, as I will have the owner of the XWF as well as the champion, Hulk Hogan, in a one-on-one interview right here tonight. Oh, Slaughter just got caught from behind by DiBiase.
Yeah, that's called what's good for the goose is good for the gander. They did that earlier on, didn't they?
Sergeant Slaughter with the Irish whip to the ropes, back out front, back body drop. And now going for the cover, Orndorff looking up at the lights, there's two, and he just barely got the shoulder up. Slaughter nearly put him away with that big shot right down, and now Orndorff with a suplex.
Well, you see Duggan out there trying to tag in, but I'm not sure how big an effort that was. And look at this, Slaughter's been busted open as well. These two American heroes are spilling blood all over the XWF.
Not the first time that Sergeant Slaughter, look out! The million-dollar dream is on, and Sergeant Slaughter in trouble.
Well, look at that, the million-dollar dream, which is really just another version of the Cobra Clutch, isn't it?
Indeed it is, and DiBiase did more damage to Slaughter, who has not been able to get up. Orndorff tagged in now, and he is waiting for what could be the final nail in the coffin. Has him up, and if this is a pile driver, nobody hits it like Mr. Wonderful. Covered, hooks a leg, there's one, and a save made by Duggan.
Well, if it weren't for Duggan breaking up the pin, it would have been over. And look at the blood-stained body of Hacksaw Jim Duggan. How much more can he possibly have in this match? And Slaughter's not far behind.
Oh, this one is getting out of control now. Look at him, choking him out. He's choking him out in the corner.
Well, referee apparently was busy with something else on the other side. Wasn't calling for the break. And now Slaughter, hey, he's been in some battles in the past. He'll have to draw on some of that perhaps to get himself out of trouble. But right now, he's in trouble.
Again, they tie up, and now Sergeant Slaughter, what's he got in mind here? Big suplex takes him all the way over. The inverted atomic knee drop. Oh, they collide.
Yep, they just banged heads together, which is going to do more damage to Sergeant Slaughter than it will Mr. Wonderful.
Again, Orndorff dropping that fist, and Sergeant Slaughter, look at Orndorff, once again showing the sign of the money. Tag is made, and now here comes Duggan.
Right now, I love the chances for the Million Dollar Team. They seem to be in complete control of this match.
Belly to back, into an atomic knee drop, and now Duggan in trouble, and here's a tag made by Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. And indeed, the Million Dollar Team, I've got to agree, fighting very well together here tonight. Not looking like a first-time demon, but Duggan hammered away on Ted DiBiase.
Well, not sure where he got the second win from, but I'll tell you, Duggan's got to be getting weak at this point in time. When you start losing that much blood, it's going to make you weaker, not stronger. And sooner or later, he's going to need medical attention if this doesn't stop.
Oh, driving the knees into the lower back. And Duggan looking to the crowd once again. There's a tag made to Sergeant Slaughter. Irish Whip sends DiBiase to the ropes. Nice drop down by Slaughter. Went for the cannon clothesline, and DiBiase was ready.
Well, Ted DiBiase, very familiar with Sergeant Slaughter and understood what was going to be waiting for him when he came off those ropes, and he proved he was ready.
Once again, shout out to everybody joining us here live on the Nation Network tonight. Stunner off the apron. And there goes Duggan.
Shout out to Retro Wrestling Networks here in the house along with Dave's Faves. Welcome aboard, gentlemen.
Referee starting to count right now. It's Slaughter fighting almost a desperate battle outside the ring here with Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Yeah, I would say it's a desperate battle. Take a look at the friggin' war stains all over the ring, all over the outside. These mats are splotched with blood, and that belongs to both Hacksaw Jim Duggan and Sergeant Slaughter. None of it belongs to DiBiase. None of it belongs to Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Orndorff beats the count. Slaughter better hurry up. He couldn't beat the count back in, and it's going to be a count-out win for the Million Dollar Team. Can you believe it?
I can believe it. Like I said, DiBiase, money is no object, and the sky is the limit. The Million Dollar Team doing a tremendous job here tonight.
Wrestling fans, right after this program is done, enter the danger zone. Jump over and check out J-Rock 73. Tell him Vince sent you.
All right, fans, we are back. More wrestling action featuring the Cruiserweight division. As we take a look at AJ Styles heading to the ring, this young man really lighting it up in that cruiserweight matchup for the championship a few weeks ago.
Yeah, he came real close. I thought he might have it. End of the day, it didn't go his way, but it's only a matter of time before he gets another crack at the strap, and it's going to be interesting because he's definitely one of the ones to watch here when it comes to the cruiserweight division. There's a lot of guys now wanting to get in the front door. I say welcome one, welcome all, because they're a very exciting brand of wrestling.
No doubt about it. These high flyers, death defiers, they can do it all, and they prove it week in and week out here in the XWF. And here comes the Cruiserweight Champion. This is a non-title matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Jushin Thunder Liger, and wait a minute. AJ Styles not gonna wait on the champion as this action takes place right here in the aisle.
Well, to say that he's got some, perhaps a taste of bad grapes in his mouth after the way that match ended. He was so close to getting up the ladder and preventing Jushin Thunder Liger from pulling the strap down. And he feels had it been a one-on-one match, things may have ended differently. Well, time will tell, I suppose.
Shout out to Dale Sandiford joining us here live on the Nation Network for XWF action. Once again, major announcement is coming in just a few moments here as I will have Hulk Hogan, the owner of the XWF and the champion, up in the ring.
Well, Hogan, not just the XWF champion, of course, he is also the WWF champion, and boy, oh boy, don't they want that belt back.
This match, not even a match yet, as it's all taking place here in the aisle. Referee might have to make a decision here pretty quickly as to whether or not he's going to let these two men compete tonight, or perhaps he's going to have to disqualify, throw the match out.
Wouldn't be surprising to me one way or another. Look at AJ, just sends him crashing into the apron down there by the ring. And now what?
Swing and a miss. Irish whip reverse, and now into the ring. And perhaps, yes indeed, the referee rings the bell, and this is now officially underway. AJ Styles, oh, what a nice move right there.
Yeah, had that hammer lock on there, turned it into a suplex. Gotta kind of like the way that turned out.
Thank you, 2K, you piece of shit. We'll be back.
Wrestling fans, right after this program is done, enter the danger zone. Jump over and check out J-Rock 73. Tell him Vince sent you. It's time to grab your popcorn and your soda. Get your favorite candy and get ready because we are going to the movies. We're going to be watching and reviewing some of the most iconic movies featuring superstars of the world of professional wrestling. Will it be thumbs up or thumbs down? We'll give you our thoughts. You give us yours. Come check us out as we review some of the greatest titles in its genre. make sure you check out the Nation Network as we take you to the movies.
How does it make you feel sitting here knowing that you're a what if? I feel like I know Brian Pillman Jr. pretty well. Like, we go way back, right?
Yeah, he was a good kid.
I don't feel like I know Lexus King at all. Macy, this is the most unique path I think that someone's taken after leaving WWE, because for most people, it's like immediately onto the indies.
Like I say, the difference between wrestling and pro sports is it doesn't matter about how talented you are.
What was that final episode of ECW like?
I didn't think it was going to be over.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. If you don't wrestle again, you're going to go down as one of the biggest what-ifs in wrestling history. Because you've got people like John Cena and Triple H and Kurt Angle and Shawn Michaels saying you're the next great thing.
You know, I did WWE for 7 years, and it was never my passion. I never, you know, that was never a secret.
It matters about whoever's writing the script, how they perceive you.
But I wouldn't sound what if. I'm a what can and what will be. My story's not over.
Also, you know, and I wasn't drinking the Kool-Aid going, I believed in the product, and I believed in Paul, and I believed in everybody in the locker room.
Yeah.
So if that's drinking the Kool-Aid, then I was.
Well, we're going to try it again, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, one thing's for sure, predictable is definitely a key graphic right here, and that is the fact that UK still can't make a game that doesn't crash in the beginning.
Yeah, we've got at least another 2 to 3 months to look forward to. But we will find a way to battle through it. Once again, the Cruiserweight Champion going one-on-one here with AJ Styles in a non-title match. We already saw some bad blood at the start of this match. Irish Whip sends him to the ropes, back out front. Tilt to World Backbreaker, nicely done right there.
Jushin Thunder Liger right now calling for the fans. I'll tell you, back in his hometown, he wouldn't have to do that. Back in Japan, he's basically as big a name as anyone you've got here in North America.
Indeed. The Japanese look to the professional wrestlers the way that we do in this country many times. Super athletes, whether it be the NFL, Major League Baseball, they're just household names.
Well, I might say that about the professional wrestlers.
Well, indeed. Don't take anything away from them. And now, big right hand to the midsection. AJ Styles with the Irish Whip sends him back, and they collide, knocking heads together. And now, Jushin Thunder Liger is up and dropped head first into the turnbuckle. He's out.
That might be enough for the win right there.
Oh, he manages to kick out very quickly. I thought he was going to be a lot closer to three than that.
As did I. I mean, the way his head snapped off that turnbuckle, I thought he was unconscious. See, that's the advantage when you're wearing a mask. You really can't tell if your opponent is injured or not, or how bad it may be, because you can't see any of the facial expressions.
Styles now continuing to stomp away. Now what? Springboard down across the back. Jushin Thunder Liger up against the ropes, and here comes AJ with a clothesline, sends him out to the floor. This battle continues here ringside. Oh, nice up kick right there by the champion to get out of trouble.
Yeah, he's a smart man. I mean, you take nothing away from Jushin Thunder Liger.
Oh, good Lord! That spike pile driver dropping him on his head right here on the floor. AJ Styles has got to be done.
I don't know where he's getting it from, but AJ Styles finding a way to fight back here. That should have been a move that would have ended anybody. He dropped him straight down on his head.
Oh, that was a brutal, brutal maneuver. This is becoming personal between these two men.
Well, anytime the championship is involved, there's always going to be a big battle. Doesn't matter if you're fan favorite or not. At the end of the day, everybody wants the gold around their waist, because with the gold comes the money.
Indeed. Irish whip to the turnbuckle, and now AJ Styles caught once again. And Liger trying to rile up this crowd here tonight. Both these men really laying it all on the line. They both want the win, even though the title not on the line. If you're the champion, you don't want to be seen as weak by coming up on the losing end.
Well, I hate to say it, but you actually make a good point with that, because that's exactly right. The champion is kind of the head of the pride, and you have to make sure all these young lions know you're the boss.
Into the corner he comes, and Liger follows it up. AJ in trouble. Boy, this AJ Styles really impressing me here tonight with the amount of punishment he has taken and to still come battling back the way he has.
Won't get any argument for me. Look at what's he got going on here. Rolls through. He's got that leg caught up. Oh, and he's putting all kinds of pressure on the calf right there. You see how bad he's bending that thing backwards, using his own leg for added leverage. Smart move right there.
Indeed, if you take away a leg from Jushin Thunder Liger, you take away a lot of the high risk, high reward. And look at this. Styles clash. He got him. Rolls it up. This could be a big win for AJ Styles. Here's two. Oh, my goodness. Liger somehow out the back.
Well, that would have been a massive victory right there for AJ Styles in this battle for the Cruiserweight Championship. Title might not be on the line here tonight, but don't doubt for a minute that's what this is all about.
Talking about big-time fights, this is definitely one of them. Jushin Thunder Liger went for the heel kick. Not going to connect with it, but AJ comes up with one of his own. And now Liger brings him back into the corner, head first into the turnbuckle. Look at Liger using that top rope for added leverage.
Well, that's very simple, or similar, I should say, to what AJ did earlier with the leg, using his own leg as added leverage. This time, the only difference is Liger used the top rope.
Big slam, and AJ coming off that top turnbuckle and landing hard into the middle of the ring. Liger perhaps believing he's ready to put this one away. And up to the top rope he goes. Went for it. Shooting star press. Nobody home.
Well, that's why it's called high risk, high reward.
Deep arm drag now by AJ Styles. Liger slowly to his feet. Pop up. Oh, wait a moment. AJ Styles clash. That's a second time.
I don't think he's going to be able to get out of it a second time.
He does. He got out. And now AJ takes him down with a cross face, pulling back on the head of the champion.
Well, the referee is right there to see if he wants to give it up. What a tremendous matchup we're getting right here tonight.
Irish whip to the ropes, back out front, went for the spinning heel, nobody home. And now down across the shoulder, nicely done by AJ Styles. The champion right now not looking so good. Oh, Styles went for the high risk.
Springboard off the middle rope, nobody home, and both of these dudes have been taking some big chances, and it hasn't paid off. I'll say this right now, if one of them connects with one of those moves, it should be the end of the match.
Liger has them all. Oh my goodness, a cradle brainbuster.
Too close to the ropes, and the referee's not going to count it, although I feel he should have.
Liger now perched on the top. There's that shooting star. This time it connects, and to your point, will that be enough?
Well, he goes for the cover, but he allowed a few seconds to pass. Will it matter?
It does, as AJ Styles able to get that shoulder off the canvas. And now, look at this, the bow and arrow. Stretching the back of AJ Styles, who comes out of it. Cross body for the cover, and then out the back door comes the champion. Went for the suplex, couldn't hold him. AJ Styles now from behind with a forearm shot. has him again, rolls through, and again has that. I don't know what you want to call it.
Well, I call it a calf crusher.
Calf, oh, look out. Styles clash. Third time is in a charm.
There's no way he's kicking out of it a third time. No way.
He does. Oh, my goodness. AJ Styles can't believe it.
Generally speaking, nobody kicks out of it once, much less three times in a match. Give it up for the champion. I mean, who else could possibly sustain that kind of punishment and still keep going?
Oh, Styles right now, he is fit to be tight. Wait a minute, what's he got in mind here? What does he want? Styles through the roll to the top. Oh, and he wipes it out.
Somersault splash right down onto the floor on top of the champion. And AJ's, oh wait, we've got blood. We've got blood, and that's got to be from the champion because AJ doesn't have any.
I believe I do see it streaming from under the mask somewhere. Hard to tell where the actual injury is. Back to your point earlier about the mask hiding a lot of detail, but at this point, I think the cat's out of the bag. Oh, wow, look at how much he is losing. AJ Styles now has got the champion into the steel steps.
I'll tell you right now, last time I saw this much blood being donated, there was a truck.
AJ, oh, he got on the neck breaker. Did you see his foot getting caught on the top of the guardrail?
Yeah, this has really become a one-sided match now, and the challenger, not well, again, the title not on the line, but AJ Styles giving the champion everything he has and then some.
Styles back in the ring, the champion in a lot of trouble. And now from the top rope, Liger slowly getting back up. Oh, and he manages to get out of the way. Can he put some offense together? Imagine if he were to pull out a win here tonight.
Well, it could happen, but I'll tell you, I would be shocked and amazed.
Look at this, diving through the ropes, a suicide dive onto AJ Styles.
Funny thing is, no matter how much damage has gone back and forth between these two dudes, they are willing to keep on leaving it all on the line.
As much as that Cruiserweight Championship means to both of these men, right now, it's a battle of pride. That's all that's on the line here tonight, really. Again, the count starting to climb. Liger back onto the bottom rope. Through the ropes he comes, and now Liger. Nice head scissor all the way around, and down goes AJ Styles. Shot to the midsection, and now let's see what Jushin Thunder Liger has in mind. Running powerbomb, but into the ropes.
Well, that's a bad mistake to be making when you're a champion, because there's no way you're going to get a pin like that. You've got to know where you're at in the ring. You've got to present yourself and position yourself so that you can hit that move and still be away from the ropes. Ring awareness, I talk about it all the time.
Oh, nice move by Styles to get out of trouble. Can he finish him off? Nice arm drag, perfectly executed by AJ. Irish whip once again to the ropes. Deep arm drag, and again the champion being thrown about the ring here. There's the pop. Oh, it's going to be the fourth time. That's got to be it. Styles clash, turns him over.
And to my point, away from the rope. He kicked out. No way. No way.
I've seen it all now, ladies and gentlemen. Big drop kick by AJ Styles. Go for the cover. He can't even get up.
Well, both of these dudes right now are absolutely exhausted. They got nothing left to give.
Oh, they're going to have to reach deep down inside because the match isn't over yet. And they're going to have to find something to give. AJ Styles always thinking right now. And what's he got in mind here? Going all the way up to the top rope. Styles drives an elbow right to the chest. Hooks the leg. Will that be enough?
Holy cow. Styles might want to look underneath the ring and see if there's a tranquilizer gun.
Unbelievable. This match continuing. Neckbreaker and Liger down again. Oh, these two. Oh, look at this. He rolls him up. Cradle by the champion. It'll be a stolen victory if he can get away with it.
And that's the whole thing right there. You never know when something like that can come out. Juice and Thunder Liger, as quick as a cat, even after being beaten into oblivion, still has the wherewithal to look for that kind of an opportunity. And you can surprise somebody with a move like that.
Liger making a comeback. Ducks underneath off the ropes. Pop up, drop kick, and down goes AJ Styles.
Talk about match of the year contenders. You're looking at one right here. These two dudes have done it all.
Again, the shooting star referee is in position, looking at the shoulders of AJ, and he kicks out.
How much more can you do? How much more can you take?
Brainbuster, AJ's out.
Well, we'll find out in a moment, because look at this. Back to the top rope once again.
Again with that shooting star press, but too close to the ropes once again. You've heard the old saying, saved by the bell. This time AJ was saved by the ropes. Liger wants him up. Crossbody, AJ Styles caught him. Oh, he's gonna go for the Styles Clash once more. And he hooks him up. That's about the fifth time, and he still kicks out.
I'm at a loss for words right now. I've got no idea what you've got to do to keep either of these down. But I'll say one thing for Juice and Thunder Liger. This is a superhuman effort on his part. He's taken so much punishment, so much damage, and we don't know what's going on underneath that mask. But there is so much blood right now that you have to believe it's really bad.
There's that calf crusher that you referred to once again, going after the leg. He's tapping out, but it doesn't count outside the ring.
If he had done that to him inside the ring, it would be all over.
Fans, I'll tell you right now, I have seen a lot over my years, but I don't think I have ever seen a beating that comes close to this one. Cross body from the top to the floor. Liger still holding his leg.
Well, the one good thing for Liger is that move by AJ just broke the referee's count and starts it back over at one. Although I'm not sure that's such a good thing at all. And AJ Styles, smart move right there, drop kicking the knee, and continues to work on the lower body of Juice and Thunder Liger.
I've got to believe the referee at some point in time has to stop this match. The amount of blood, and you can't tell where the actual injury is, but Liger just continues to fight through it. He absolutely will not stop. Head first into the steel post. That's not going to help. Liger is stunned on the floor. AJ Styles is in the ring, and this is going to be a win for AJ Styles.
Well, I'm not sure that's the kind of win you want to have, but I don't know if there was another way to get it, because look at this.
A sign of mutual respect. Oh, Liger saying no, thank you. Fans will be back in just a moment with more. Stay with us here on the Nation Network.
Here we go. BK. Oh, my God, and the match has begun. Oh, God! Oh, my God.
Looking for some game-banging action?
Holy hell. Wait, Sam is gone. I heard that you can catch chairs. We should try this.
Not just playing games, but breaking games.
Oh no! Oh, no. So James did a finisher on the top to me and threw me off to the left side of the screen and put me in the crowd and everyone around me thought that was hilarious. And shouts out to the 2K team member that said, "Wow, I should have known that New Legacy was going to be best."
You know the old saying, and if it isn't broke, don't fix it? Yeah, neither do these guys.
Jesus is eliminated.
Jesus and Santa not having a good night.
No!
From the guys who never met a game they couldn't break, check out New Legacy.
Well, fans, we've cleaned the area up during the commercial break, but holy cow! As we take a look at one half of the World Tag Team Champions, Scott Steiner in a lot of controversy right now regarding the tag team titles. Well, I don't know about the controversy, really. I don't think there is any controversy. The fact of the matter is, both Steiner brothers have been beaten singles, and they've been beaten as a tag team by the crown. And tonight, it's going to be another one-on-one match. But I got news for you. Sooner or later, they're going to have to put those titles on the line, and I believe it's going to be sooner.
King Harley Race getting ready to head to the ring for this matchup.
Indeed, Harley Race, one of the kings of wrestling. Along with the King Jerry Lawler, together they form the crown.
Well, I'm going to let you in on a little something. I was talking to Jerry Lawler earlier on tonight. He wouldn't talk to you, I know that, but he talks to me.
Is that a fact? And did he have any words of wisdom to part?
Well, I'll tell you what he did say. He's not going to show his full hand, but he did tell me whenever you have a crown, you have to have a crown jewel.
Crown jewel?
That's right, crown jewel.
What does that mean?
I don't know. He didn't tell me what it meant, but knowing Jerry Lawler the way I do, it means something. We'll find out.
Bell sounds, action's underway as these two tie up in the middle of the ring. What a night of wrestling we've had for you, ladies and gentlemen, here in the XWF. That last match is one that's going to go down in the annals of wrestling history here on the Nation Network.
Yeah, definitely going to be one of the all-time greats. What an unbelievable match we saw here tonight. That was without the title being on the line.
Cross-body block by Steiner. Caught Harley Race up high. Driving the former World Heavyweight Champion down. These Steiner brothers, I'll tell you, they're a couple of very powerful individuals, very tremendous all-around athletes, and of course, their amateur wrestling activities have been well documented. The University of Michigan, both standout stars there on that team.
They've transitioned to the world of professional wrestling very easily, very smoothly, and they've been dominant in many ways, but the crown has had their number.
Well, it's hard to argue with that. As Harley Race driving that knee right into the head of Scott Steiner. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, a major announcement coming up later tonight. I will have Hulk Hogan in the ring to find out what that announcement is. Be here with us.
as Harley Race unloads.
You don't even know what the announcement is, do you?
I do not. That's why it's a major announcement.
I thought you and Hogan were buddy-buddy. I figured he would have told you something.
And now Harley Race going after the knee. Goes for the cover. Steiner's down, but he doesn't hook the leg.
Yeah, I've got to admit, that's a pretty bad mistake to make right there. I would expect more from Harley Race.
Gut wrench suplex takes him all the way over. What a move right there by King Harley Race. Going up to the top rope now. Dahl, the elbow right into the head.
Yeah, I don't know that's what he was aiming for, because it looked like he may have hurt himself a little bit on that one coming down, but it definitely did a number on Scott Steiner. Could have a concussion the way he hit him with that.
Oh, and a headbutt, that one connected.
Yeah, now I'd say he probably does have a concussion.
King Harley Race going for the cradle suplex. And he bridges up, shoulders are down, will that be enough? There's two, he got no. Scott Steiner somehow managing to kick out, and Harley Race went for the knee again. The crowd over there screaming, fight forever.
Well, be careful what you wish for, because after that last match, you might just get it.
Went for the Steiner line, nobody home, and now they exchange blows. Back and forth right here in the middle of the ring. Look at Steiner hammering away. Open hand slap by Harley Race. Again and again. Oh, and he's busted him open.
He just did. He split him wide open right over the right eye. And now Harley Race, not a happy camper.
Would you know the difference? When is he ever? Now Harley Race going up to the top rope very quickly. Steiner got caught with that axe handle to the head.
He crowned him.
Indeed, he did. And now Harley Race waiting, biding his time. Gonna try it again. Cradle plex. He's in the ropes.
Yeah, once again, making that mistake right there. You gotta be careful about that. You're not going to have too many opportunities to put a guy like Steiner away. You got to make the most of him.
Scott Steiner now firing back, and I would dare say that Steiner needs this win. Oh, a Steiner driver! That's got to be it! He's got the cover! And Harley Race somehow able to kick out of that!
Well, he does somehow. I don't know how. That is an absolutely terrific move right there by Steiner, and it's a move that can end the career, much less end a match.
Harley Race now heading over to the corner. Steiner is right there on top of him, and now, oh, what's he gonna do here? Takes him all the way across, corner to corner, post to post, and here he goes again.
Driving the back of the ribs, crushing Harley Race right now. And look at that move. What a tremendous suplex right there.
Full Nelson into a suplex, and Harley Race. Oh, my goodness. Scott Steiner now running. Power slam drives the former champion into the mat. Scott Steiner dominating this match right now. Going for the butterfly suplex. Oh, sit-out bomb. Wow, the momentum has really swung in favor of Scott Steiner in this match.
Yeah, it's definitely come all the way around at this point in time. There's no doubt about it. How much more can either of these dudes have? But Harley Race right now going into the deep water, as they say, as the clock ticks along, and Father Time is a friend to no one.
Tilt a world slam, and now Scotty winds up the arm. Big right cross to the jaw. And again, gonna go for that cradle plex, and again has him in the ropes, but the referee gonna allow it. There's one, and he kicks out. Wow, the power, the strength the tenacity. Want to welcome everyone joining us here live on the Nation Network. Neil Hooper's in the house. Judd is here as well.
Also got Big JH in the house. Welcome aboard XWF Wrestling Action at its finest.
And for the second time tonight, we see a serious injury. As you take a look at Harley Race, the amount of blood he is losing right now. There's a Frankensteiner on the concrete floor. Steiner continues to hammer away on the former champion.
Well, you got to realize something. The Steiner brothers have been beaten on a regular basis by members of the Crown, and they don't want to just get a win here tonight, and they're not going to. If he gets the win at all, he's done it the way he needs to, because he is punishing Harley Race here.
Yeah, I've got to admit, I'm a little surprised to not see Jerry Lawler or Rick Steiner at ringside for a match like this.
Well, personally, I'm glad they're not. I want to see this one end one-on-one. Let's get a victory. Let's prove something here tonight.
Belly to belly suplex, nicely done by Harley Race. Steiner favoring the back after that one, and now Harley Race with a headbutt. Oh, he came crashing down. He's got him cradled up. There's nowhere to go.
Oh, what happened to the three count? It took him an extra second to kick out. The referee had already stopped counting. What is this, presumptuous kickouts or something that we're counting on?
Stunner off that top rope. And the referee indeed seems to be a little slow on the third count. For those of you just joining us, ladies and gentlemen, we have a major announcement coming up later tonight. The owner of the XWF, Hulk Hogan, will be here along with me here in the ring. Big right hand caught him. Russian leg sweep on the floor. Now Harley Race starting to get the momentum back.
Well, he's going to need something because he's a mess. Nothing new for Harley Race. He's been in bloodbaths before. He, the Nature Boy Ric Flair for the NWA World Championship. Battles they've had inside of steel cages. It's all been documented.
Oh, look, he tried for the cradle but couldn't grab the leg, and Steiner slips out. And now Steiner has him up. Oh, there it is again, the Steiner driver.
Referee calls for the rope break, and that may have just saved Harley Race here tonight.
Harley Race up against the ropes, and now here comes Rick Steiner. All right, beg your pardon, Scott Steiner with that Steiner line, sending him to the floor. Oh, this is chaos at its best, ladies and gentlemen. Back and forth. And now, Steiner going up top. What's he got in mind? Driving the elbow right into the chest, and he's going to go up again.
Well, I'll tell you one thing from experience. I find that if you go to the well one time too often, it's going to backfire on you.
He connected with the big splash. And now it appears that Scott Steiner has also been busted open. Frankensteiner, he got him.
Well, he got him, but he didn't hook the leg, and that's a problem. He should have.
Steiner has him up. Oh, I think we know what's coming next. Oh, the Steiner driver, brutal maneuver. This time he's got to pull him away from the ropes.
Well, smart move right there to go for that. Now goes for a quick cover. Will it be enough?
Harley Race got a shoulder up somehow. Steiner sends him to the ropes, back out front. What a move! Sends him tumbling over the top and crashing to the floor.
This is the XWF at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. You're looking at two major names in the world of professional wrestling. They are letting it all hang out here tonight.
I don't know how many more ring canvases we can go through tonight. Harley Race going for the cover. Got two. And almost.
It was almost because Steiner barely kicked out of that one. Barely kicked out.
And now choking away. Harley Race now. What's he got in mind here? Look at this. Taking off the turnbuckle pad. Drives the knee right into the face of Steiner, and now Scotty in trouble. Harley Race bringing him over to the corner. Exposed ring head first.
Well, smart move right there by Harley Race, trying to take one of the legs away.
Continues to stomp away. And now Harley Race going up. Oh, the headbutt connects. That's got to be it. One, two. He got no. Steiner kick it out.
Harley Race can't believe it. I can't believe it. And this crowd is on its feet because they can't believe it.
Irish whip over the top rope. Big right hand. Another. And out to the floor. Harley Race outside the ring now with Scott Steiner. Referee just starting his count. There's that cradle plex on the floor. Good Lord.
That's going to do a lot of damage. And look at Steiner. He's not even moving. He's not even moving. The referee should get down there and check on him. He's probably really badly hurt.
If he's not, he certainly looks like it. Harley Race, so I thought he was going to throw him back in the ring.
Well, it looked like he had a second thought after a moment, but that was a mistake.
Back underneath the bottom rope, and now Steiner follows him in. Boot to the midsection. Series of chops and shots, and now Scott Steiner with a float over. Now what's he got in mind? Harley Race barely able to get to his feet. Steiner has him up. Steiner driver, perhaps. It is. That's got to be it.
Goes for the immediate cover. Referee's in position for the count. This might be all.
How in the world is he doing it?
Well, I've said it about Harley Race many times here. He is leather tough. He's an old tough veteran. He's built thick. And he is able to withstand so much punishment as we are seeing right here tonight.
Splash off the top rope a la Superfly Jimmy Snuka. And now doing further damage to the head of Harley Race. Look at this ring. Shoulder tackle. Man, this is brutal. Ties him up and now walks him over. Head first into the turnbuckle. And now Scott's got him on top. Scotty Steiner, what's he got in mind here? Is this what I think it's going to be? Frankensteiner on the top rope. It's over. Go for the cover.
He's got him in the middle of the ring. There's nowhere to go for Harley Race.
He got a shoulder up. Can you believe this?
Personally, no, I can't.
Scott Steiner, probably a little amazed himself. He's going to try for the Steiner driver, I believe. He does.
There's no way he can keep kicking out of this.
Referee in position, and again. Oh, Harley Race is acting purely on instinct at this point in time. There is just no way. Elbow right to the small of the back. Back in underneath the bottom rope, and now Harley Race going up to the top rope. Let's see what happens here. Steiner caught him and makes him pay.
You see how Harley Race just landed in that ring head first.
Driving the knee into the head of Scotty Steiner. And now Race going up to the top. Could be the headbutt, perhaps. Drops the elbow.
Harley Race has something in mind, I can only imagine.
Cradle Plexi's gonna try it again. And he hangs on to it. Will that be enough? One, two, he kicked out.
For the second time tonight, we've got two guys out there that absolutely refuse to lose. And when that happens, you get some of the best wrestling, and that's what we're bringing you right here, right now.
Harley Race here ringside. What is it going through the mind of the king? Oh, the headbutt right to the orbital bone. Steiner might be out. Referee's count is up 7. I don't think Scott Steiner's going to get back up.
Well, he's getting up. Will he be able to get back in the ring within the next 2 seconds? He does.
To the Rolls, back out front. Caught him and drives him into the canvas. Shoulder tackle, down he goes. Hurricane Rana. Steiner driver goes for the cover, hooks the leg. Will I be enough this time? No.
Man, I've seen it all right now. How in the world, what do you gotta do to put this man away? That Frankensteiner was pinpoint precision right there.
And now it is Harley Race going for that cradle suplex, but again into the ropes.
Both of these men have really put it all out there. Both of these men are never going to be the same when this match is over.
Race running right into him with that knee, striking him in the chin. Again, that elbow drop, over 265 pounds coming down on the chest of Scott Steiner.
If I was Harley Race, I'd go for that pile driver one more time. Oh, his back gave out on him.
He crawls over, has the arm across Steiner, two, he, oh my goodness, almost got him.
He went for that cradle plex one more time, but then the back gave out on him and he couldn't hold on to it.
And now Scott Steiner belly to back suplex and Harley Race down on the back of his head. Fans, we are running over time. We ask the nation to stay with us. Steiner now working on the head and the neck of King Harley Race.
Yeah, and I happen to notice that his foot was underneath the rope, so why was the referee not calling for a rope break?
Steiner has him up, not again, not again, there's a Steiner driver, it's gotta be over. It's gotta be.
I've never seen anything like this in my entire career. And I've seen a lot of stuff, let me tell you what. To be dropped on your head like that 4 or 5 times now, I've lost count.
Steiner sends him to the ropes, back out front. Overhead, no, look at the block by Harley Race.
He was going for an overhead belly to belly is what it looked like, but it didn't happen because Harley Race, the wily veteran, able to not only stop him, but look at that beautiful butterfly suplex.
Harley Race now heading back up to the top, maybe, maybe the headbutt. It is, oh my goodness, that one did as much damage to Harley Race.
Yeah, with that open wound, I don't know if that's a smart move or not.
Steiner able to kick out, but this has got to be coming to an end. There's that cradle suplex. He's got it. He's holding on. Will that be enough? Steiner kicks out.
Well, the back and forth on this one is absolutely unbelievable. How these two guys are still wrestling at this point, I've got no idea.
Action outside the ring right now. Who's going to pull it off? It will either of them pull it off. Steiner now going up to the top rope. Caught him on a Steiner line.
That might be enough. That might be enough.
Still kicks out. And another Frankensteiner.
Had a chance right there to put it away. Should have gone for the cover.
Steiner driver. On my head. He just nails him. And again, too close to the ropes. Fans, we got to take a commercial break. If the match should end, we will show you what happened when we return. Stay with us.
Attention wrestling fans, if you're having a great time here on the Nation Network, then we encourage you to go visit Dre 41 right after this program. Dre 41 with some of the greatest hockey action you've ever seen, featuring games from Japan that you won't see in the United States. Whether it's professional wrestling, boxing, or just an overall good time, get spicy with Dre 41.
Well, the action continuing here in the ring. During the commercial break, more damage being done to Harley Race. Follows it up with a clothesline, and now Steiner.
Scott Steiner has tried, but has not been able to put him away. He's tried everything in the book, and then some. He's got him overhead, belly to belly, nicely done.
Dead lifting him off the canvas. That is not an easy task to do, especially this late in the match.
Both of these men are absolutely spent. They are exhausted and yet still finding a way to come up with even more punishment for one another.
Steiner catches him. Tilt the world slam, and now Harley Race in a lot of trouble. Went for the Steiner line, nobody home. Harley Race, what's he doing here? Taking off the turnbuckle pad.
Well, the referee saw it. He's allowing it, at least for the moment. We'll see how long for.
Oh, up kick that was. And now Scott Steiner starting to turn things back around. Referee paying attention now to the turnbuckle pad, and Steiner with a hot shot. Going out with a cover, hooking a leg, Harley Race. Oh, that's three right there, come on.
Well, the referee had to deal with that turnbuckle pad, as you mentioned, had to put it back on.
Steiner gonna go for that Steiner driver. How much more can these two men give and take? Steiner again with that tilt-a-whirl splash. Got the cover, hook and a leg one, and Harley Race out the back door.
Steiner wants him back up on his feet, but be careful what you want because you might just get it.
Oh, he rolls him up, shoulders are down. Referee there for one, and Harley coming out the back. And now unload. Back and forth, they still been exchanging blows. That one was blocked, nicely done by Harley Race. Clothesline and down goes Steiner. Harley Race now going all the way up to the top. He watched him up. I thought he was going to go for the headbutt and put it away, perhaps. He crowns him. And the headbutt, that's got to be all she wrote. Hooks the leg. One, two, three. Well, that was a major victory, no doubt about it, but what a battle was fought here tonight, and neither of these two men are going to be the same when it's over. There's just no way. Harley Race not done yet. He's got the steel chair. Give me a break. He's going to use the steel chair. Here comes. That's one of the British Bulldogs, Davey Boy Smith. What is he doing here? He's got no business in this. All right, fans, the main event of the evening, and we still haven't heard from Hulk Hogan.
It's scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from the Rocky Mountains, weighing in at 450 pounds, the man they call Vader.
Well, shout out to everybody joining us here live on the Nation Network, including Scott W. in the house, James Weston and Andrew Roberts. Welcome aboard, everyone. Indeed, this is the main event, and I am told that I will be interviewing Hulk Hogan following this matchup, so stick around. We're going to find out what this major announcement is here in the XWF. Vader, one of the most dominant forces in the history of professional wrestling, but especially here in the XWF, crossing the line to sign.
Well, we've seen him have battles in recent weeks with the likes of the Ultimate Warrior. Tonight he goes up against somebody else that likes to wear face paint, but we know the real goal for Vader is always going to be the World Championship, and that right now, of course, is Hulk Hogan.
Indeed, the icon heading down the aisle. These two no strangers to one another.
Absolutely not. These two have done battle in the past, and they're getting ready to do it up again. And then we find out what the major announcement is. And I've got to be honest with you, I'm kind of curious. I might not like Chump Hogan, but he's the owner of the company right now. He's signing the paychecks. And if it's a major announcement, I need to be a part of it.
Well, this ongoing battle between he and those in the World Wrestling Federation who would desperately love nothing more than to get their championship title back. Bell sounds, action's underway as the two tie up. And look at Vader just throwing Sting down and making it look easy. Sting with a clothesline doesn't move him, not even one iota. Has him up in the air. Vader just driving the Stinger face first down to the canvas.
Well, you mentioned earlier on that these are no strangers to one another. That's because it was Sting that was the WCW World Champion and Vader who took that title from him, and it was a brutal match.
Vader has had an answer for Sting early on in this one. Going for the chokeslam. Sting able to battle his way out of it. There's a bulldog.
And the Mastodon now, for the first time, showing some wear. And Sting unloading on him here in the corner with a series of chops and punches.
Well, Sting taking a moment to enjoy it, but I'll tell you, that's not the way to get it done against Vader.
Gonna pull him out of that corner, back towards the middle of the ring. Wow, he just landed. Hell of a noise that made.
Well, you're talking about nearly 400 pounds, and that's gonna make a sound when it hits the canvas.
Sting has him up. Went for the inverted, and now what's he gonna do here? Oh, I thought he's gonna go for the scorpion for a moment there. You know, we acknowledge the history between these two men, and because of that history, you have to believe, I would have to believe, that Sting really wants to get this win.
Well, I think they both want the win, and I think they both need the win because they both have points that they're trying to prove here in the XWF.
Shot to the midsection, now Sting with a clothesline. What's he doing now? Going after the table. Sting clearing the deck, so to speak. Oh, Vader just got sent crashing in there. Sting goes up there with him. Shot to the midsection, and now what's he gonna do? DDT. Stinger. Went for the splash and he missed.
Nobody home and he pays the price for that one.
Sting underneath the bottom rope, just barely making it. Vader has him up in the Vader bomb. Oh, that's all she wrote. Going for the cover. Vader with a victory.
A decisive victory, I might add.
What happened? What happened? It's the Ultimate Warrior!
The Ultimate Maniac, what's he doing here? He's got him by the throat.
Choke slam and down goes Vader. Fans will be back with Hulk Hogan in just a moment.
Eh?
What?
The 80s called. They want their store back.
It's time for a new Radio Shack. Come see what's possible when we do things together.
All right, fans, we are here right now with the World Wrestling Federation and the XWF World Heavyweight Champion, Hulk Hogan, and we've been talking about it. You have a major announcement. Tell us what's going on.
Well, let me tell you something, Mean Gene. It's like this. Right now, I am the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, man. And I am the XWF Heavyweight Champion. And I am the owner of the XWF. And that's a lot on my plate, brother. But I want to thank everyone out there, man, in the nation. All you people out there, all you Hulkamaniacs, been supporting this program week after week, whether you're here live or whether you're watching on demand, man. And we really get up for that. But the one question that everybody keeps coming to me with, the one thing I've heard over and over again is, Hulkster, when are you going to have a premium event, man? Well, you won't have to wait long, because next week, right here, the XWF will have its first ever premium event. Oh, yeah.
Are you kidding me? That 1 week's time?
That's right, man. This next week, we're going to have it right here. And I'll tell you right now, the main event, I'm going to put the XWF Heavyweight Championship on the line.
Who are you going to be going up against?
Well, that's the good part, man. Because I am a fighting champion. And I'll put this championship on the line against anybody any given day of the week. But I understand, I heard that weasel, that good-for-nothing Bobby the Brain Heenan last week come out here saying he signed two new talents, and we don't know who they are. So here's what I'm going to say. Weasel, You pick either one of those two new signings and bring them down next week, and I will put that championship on the line against them.
Are you kidding me? You're going to go into a blind title match?
That's right, brother. Next week, the XWF will be resurrected.
Resurrected?
That's right. Next week, it will be Resurrection. That's the name of the pay-per-view. But you know what? Because everybody out there's been so cool, because everybody out there's been really vibing on the XWF, man, I got one more announcement. I wasn't going to make it, but I'll make it now, man.
What is that, Hogan?
It's this. McMahon, not only have I taken your championship belts, but I've taken some of your IP as well, because here's a little thing in the world of intellectual property. There's a little thing in the world of copyrights, brother. And sometimes if you don't save them, they slip away. And I have acquired the rights to the King of the Ring tournament. And in April, we will hold the first King of the Ring tournament in almost a decade, brother, right here in the XWF.
The King of the Ring?
That's right, man. All the action you can imagine. King of the Ring, top eight competitors are going to battle it out to see who's the king.
Well, we know we've already got two of them here. What an absolute bombshell announcement, Hulk Hogan. Next week, you're going to defend the XWF Championship against a member of the Brainbusters.
That's right, man. And Bobby the Brain Heenan, and whichever jobber you want to bring out here, what you're going to do when Hulkamania runs wild on you?
We'll find out next week at Resurrection.